Hi, I'm Dan Maxfield, an agronomic service rep with Syngenta Crop Protection. And today we're standing here at the Grow More Experience site in Ephrata, Washington. And I am standing in front of the wheat fungicide trial where we are evaluating Syngenta's newest wheat fungicide for control of Fusarium head blight. And this crop was planted on the 13th of April. And the applications for head scab were done at initial flowering, just after heading at that 10% flowering, or Feeks 10.5.1, and that was done on the 20th of June. So we're gonna look through the treatments and we're gonna evaluate some of the symptomology we see with Fusarium head blight and how that disease impacts this crop as it progresses closer and closer to harvest. So today is July the 13th, and this crop was sprayed at initial flowering on June the 20th. So we've been about 23 days after application, and this wheat crop is well into grain fill and kernel development. And as you can see, we planted into corn stubble. If you notice on the ground, you will see some corn stalks and some heavy residue. It was planted into a pretty heavy residue sweet corn block from last season. So natural inoculum pressure. And what you will see is some of the initial stages of Fusarium infection on some of these wheat heads. And as we start to senesce and these heads start to turn yellow, you'll see the white parts of the head, some partial blanking, as well as when we open up those wheat heads, we will see what we call tombstones or Fusarium infected kernels. Those kernels will not fill out. They won't produce a good quality grain, as well as will be a source of inoculum of Fusarium for the following season, if it is a seed crop. Here's a very good early sign or symptom of Fusarium head blight in wheat. And if you can see here on the camera, you can tell that there's about half of the head or maybe a third of the head is white and the rest of it's green. The reason why that probably started right there in the middle, and you'll see some of these infections, a lot of them are based towards the middle of the head. And some of these center florets are the first ones to get infected. The reason being is wheat starts flowering from the center of the head and kind of moves out. So as those anthers push out of the wheat head, they become susceptible, those flowers become susceptible to infection of Fusarium as it sporulates and infects the crop. And wherever it was initial flowering started, and which was the center of the wheat head, is where you see we'll see Fusarium infection. On some of these heads, such as this one here, you'll see it on the tip. That just happened to be a susceptible or open flower at the time of Fusarium spores flying around and got this head for infection. This one's probably 50% infected that I have my hand on right now. And you can see in this crop, as we go through it, you'll see anywhere between 20 to sometimes 50, 60% of some heads infected with Fusarium, which is fairly severe from a natural pressure scenario. Treatment number two here in the Fusarium head blight block was Trivapro applied at flag leaf, full flag leaf emergence as a maintenance chemistry for stripe rust and leaf diseases. And that was applied at 13.7 fluid ounces per acre. And the Miravis Ace fungicide was applied at 13.7 fluid ounces per acre at initial flowering, or Feeks 10.5.1. And this treatment, number two, was done in a simulated aerial application at 5 gallons per acre. So if you look at this crop, I think just right out of the gate, you'll notice if you zoom in on some of these, you will still see some Fusarium infection in here. It is not as severe or probably as common within the heads. You don't see as many heads. That's one really critical component of controlling Fusarium head blight, is you need to have your fungicide on prior to disease infection. And Fusarium is a very tricky disease to time correctly, and so we always try to shoot for initial anthers. If not full head emergence right before those anthers are popping is a great time for Miravis Ace fungicide.